Let us now discuss about inertia. What is inertia? Inertia is a property which resists change. In a funny way, if you want to understand, suppose you ask a student to study, what will be his reaction? He wouldn't like to study. Okay, so his state of mind is, I should relax. But when you ask him to study, he would not like to study. So he doesn't want to change his state of mind. Although he will study, that's a different issue. So in physics also, we come across in mechanics a term called inertia. So inertia is in three types: inertia at rest, inertia at motion, inertia in direction. Okay. Now, inertia at rest. We'll understand this using some examples. Fruits falling down when branches are shaken. You take a tree, okay? When you take a tree, you know, this is a tree. Now the tree and the fruits attached to it, to its branches, is at rest. Now suddenly you violently move the tree. What will happen? The fruit, you know, it falls down. You know, this is one example of inertia at rest. Dust particles on a carpet fall if we beat the carpet. You see, basically the dust particle, suppose this is a carpet, the dust particles and the carpet both are in rest. But when you start beating the carpet, what happens is the dust particle is at rest only. But there is a violent movement in the carpet. So the dust particles stay as it is, but the carpet is, you know, because the carpet is getting violated, what happens is the dust particle, it appears that it is falling in air. It is rising in air and falling down, whatever. Similarly, if you take a table, you know, you take a table and there is a cloth and some items are kept over here. Suddenly you push the cloth. Initially the cloth and the plate on top of the table, both were at rest. Now you suddenly pulled the cloth. What happens is the plate, you know, kind of settles down. So these are some examples of inertia at rest. Inertia at rest means the object doesn't like to change its state immediately. Okay, so in these three cases, the fruit was in at rest, the dust particle was at rest, the plate was also at rest. Even though the connected object was suddenly moved, they didn't try to change their state. So this is what is inertia at rest. The next type is inertia of motion. A person getting down from a running bus, what happens? A bus is there, you know, the bus is moving and a person tries to get down. So with the bus, he will also run for some distance. If he suddenly tries to stop, he will fall down. But with the bus, actually the person in the bus is not at rest. Maybe in the bus he is at rest, but because the bus is moving, the person also has the same speed of the bus. So when he tries to get down, the land on which he is stepping relatively is at rest, looks at rest, but he has to keep running with the bus. Otherwise, he will fall down. Passengers traveling by a train fall forward when the train suddenly applies the brake. When the passengers are going in a train and suddenly the brake is applied, at that state, what happens is, with the train, the passengers also are moving. So, immediately by applying the brake, you have stopped the vehicle. But you cannot immediately stop the person who is sitting inside. So he will fall for in the forward direction. Swirling of milk in a glass continues even after the stirring is stopped. Suppose there is a container is there, you know, it contains milk, and using a spoon you kind of rotate. Then the milk in that also rotates with that. Now suddenly you stop the spoon. Will the milk stop? No, the milk keeps rotating. Because by using that spoon, when you started moving the particles of the milk, they attained a state of motion. So suddenly they will not stop. Even if you, the stirring which is caused by the spoon, even if it is removed, the particles will keep on moving for some more time and then they finally come to rest. A boy throwing a toy in the train, you know, it returns back to the boy. Suppose there is a train, okay, and there is a boy inside the train. The train is moving in this direction and the boy tries to flung a small ball. Now what happens is this ball, this boy are both going with the speed of the train only. So even though the boy flung the ball in the upward direction, the ball also travels along with the train because the ball has got the speed of the train. So after maybe 1 second or 2 seconds, the boy again catches the ball. So just by flinging the ball in the air, the ball just doesn't travel in the vertical direction only. It also has the speed of the train. So this is also an example of inertia of motion. So try to understand the difference. An object which is at rest doesn't like to change its state of rest. So for changing it, you have to give a force. This is what is Newton's first law. Similarly, an object which is in motion doesn't like to change its state of motion and suddenly wants to come to rest. It would like to continue in that motion. Even then, you have to apply a force in order to bring it to rest. The third type is inertia of direction. Okay, you can take a small thread and you can tie a stone to one of its end and you rotate in a circular way. Now let us say after some time you suddenly when the stone was rotating in that circular path, suddenly for some reason, let us say it lost contact with the thread. What will happen? It will fall off in the tangential direction. Or in this these type of amusement parks and all that, where children type of rotate in a toy horse and all that. So suddenly if it is stopped, what will happen? They will fall off in that tangential direction. So when they have stopped this directional motion, they should also stop. But they have attained a direction because of the motion, you know. And every point of time, how can you find a direction? You have to draw a tangent over there. So when it suddenly stops, the object is thrown in the tangential direction at that point of time. So this is the example of inertia of direction. The object is not able to change its direction immediately just because the motion has stopped. A dog chasing a hare. Okay, now a dog finds it difficult to chase a hare because the hare can easily change its direction, but a dog can't do that. A dog cannot change its direction so easily. It has got more inertia in terms of direction, so it finds difficult to chase down a hare, you know. Okay, and you might have experienced this also. A bus taking a sharp turn. Suppose you are going in some mountainous region where there are a lot of valleys and all that, you know. You have roads like this which are suddenly taking turns like this. Okay, what happens? A bus is going like this, the driver will suddenly rotate the steering. What will happen? We kind of fall down towards either right or to the left, and then again he will turn, then again we will fall down. So why is that happening? That is happening because you are moving in a particular direction, and when suddenly the direction is changed, you find it difficult to negotiate the turn, and you also kind of move in that kind of direction. So these are the examples of inertia of direction. These three are very important, and you need to understand the basic difference between these three. In all these cases, we need to apply a force to change its state of motion. Okay, thank you.